Hi everyone. Our today's topic is a pattern classifier. What it is? It is a pattern classifier. So now we are going to know what is a pattern classifier, which means the introduction of pattern classifier. Okay, as well as the base classifier or under this base classifier, we are going to learn Navi-based classification. These are the two topics under the pattern classifier here. Okay, let us discuss about the introduction of a pattern classifier. Under the introduction of the pattern classifier, first of all, we would see the definition of classification. Okay, first of all, we would know about the definition of classification. The classification involves predicting the item, okay, belongs to which class. Okay, which means now, for example, patterns are there. This is one pattern, assume that, and this is some other pattern. Here we have the data patterns, and this is some other pattern. Here we have some other data points we have, and okay, these are the some other data points we have. Okay, here we are having different classes of data. For this is star, this is some heart symbol, into symbol, which means tick symbol. These are the four different classes we have. Okay, for example, a new data point is there with you. Okay, assume this is new data point, whichever you have. So now you are going to predict this new data item belonging to which class. Okay, either it may be under this stars class, or under this heart symbol class, or this class. Here we are having four classes of data items. Okay, so into these four patterns, this particular new one is belongings to which pattern? It may be belong to either heart symbol, or it belongs to the tick symbol, or it belongs to a into symbol, or it belongs to a star symbol. You need to identify, or you need to predict, the given data item is belonging to which class. This kind of prediction is called the classification here. Is it clear? Right. And here we are having how many patterns are there? Here four patterns are there. Okay, one is star tick mark and as heart symbol. Here four kind of patterns are there. These four kind of patterns are called multi-class patterns. If you have more than two patterns under your particular attribute, then that particular class is called multi-class. But if you are only have two different classes, like yes or no, okay, suppose if you take one attribute, result attribute, if you take the attribute is result, how many kinds of this result attribute has only two outcomes? What are those? One is either that particular student is pass or he may fail, isn't it? He may fail. Okay, based on the percentage of that particular student, okay, we may predict that whether that particular student is pass or fail, isn't it? This one, if particular attribute has only two classes, or two outcomes, then that particular attribute is called binary, okay, binary attribute or binary class. But if a particular attribute has more than two outcomes, then that particular, okay, then particular items or attribute is commander a multi-class attribute. Is it clear? Classification means based on the new data, now we are going to predict or we are going to identify this particular data item is coming under to the which class. Okay, then after finding, after identifying, then you are going to represent this particular new data item into this group. Now here only six data points are there into this group. Automatically after adding this this one also here, we will have total seven number of stars are there into this particular group, isn't it? This is the classification definition. Identifying of a new item, it belongs to which group, that is called class, classification. Here two kinds of classifications are there based on their outcomes. One is binary, second one is multi. Binary in the sense, here we are having only two classes. Okay, class, not classes, actually class labels. Okay, pass is one class label and fail is another class label. If one particular attribute has only two class labels, then that particular attribute is called a binary attribute or binary class. Okay, if particular attribute has, okay, more than two class labels, then that particular attribute is called a multi-class. Class in the sense here, the class we may call that attribute. The attribute name is also called as class. The outcome of that particular attribute is called a class label. Clear? Here, you should remember two words. The first word is a class, second one is a class label. The class is also called as attribute. Okay. Class label is called the data under that particular attribute is called class label. Is it clear? Right. Next. So in this constant, a neural network is one of the several machine learning algorithms. Okay. So what is neural network here? Neural network is one of the several machine learning algorithms that can be helped to solve classification problems. Okay, at the starting of this unit itself, we have discussed one point under perceptrons. Perceptrons are used to, okay, used for the functions of classifications, isn't it? It is going to perform a computation or function like the classification kind of functions only it can be performed, isn't it? So this neural network, artificial neural network is also have several machine learning algorithms. Those few of those machine learning algorithms are used to solve or used to help to solve the classification problems. Classification problem in the sense, this is the classification problems, isn't it? If that particular person is got 26 marks, then he may be passed in particular subject, isn't it? So if the now student A has 26 marks, okay, based on this given data, here we are going to tell his result whether he is passed or fail into that particular subject, isn't it? This is the solution for the new data, new arrival data, isn't it? Now we are going to solve the classification problems by using perceptrons. और दिस इज वन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट इन न्यूरल नेटवर्क, इजंट इट? एंड इट हैज यूनिक स्ट्रेंथ. व्हाट इट इज नर्व? इट हैज यूनिक स्ट्रेंथ. इट इज एबिलिटी टू डायनामिकली क्रिएट कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रिडिक्शन फंक्शंस. दिस पैटर्न क्लासिफायर हैज ए unique strength. What is that unique strength of this particular algorithm? It is going to create complex predictions. Now here we are going to know the predictions, isn't it? Here also not only simple predictions, here we are going to create complex prediction functions. Complex prediction functions, that is the one of the strength of this particular algorithm, isn't it? So how it is having the strength to create complex prediction functions and emulate human thinking in a way that no algorithms can, which means how a human can think about some new data items based on his past knowledge, based on some history of that particular item. How a human being can identify, can classify the new data items based on its futures. In the same manner, these algorithms also worked to predict the new data items. That particular new data item is belong to which class, we are going to identify that. Okay, in such a manner the machine learning algorithms are there here, not only machine neural networks algorithms, isn't it? And coming to the next point, here there are many classification problems are there. There are many classification problems are there for which a neural network have yielded the best results. Okay. So for which classification problems the neural network would give the best results? Okay. Such kind of classification problems are there. Okay. Many are there in the neural network. Okay, what are the classification problems under this neural network? Okay, there are, first one is logistic regression. What is the first one is logistic regression? Sorry, not regression. It is a logistic regression. It is one kind of classifier type which produce which kind of outcome it is going to give. It's a binary class. Binary class in the sense it produce only two kind of class labels. One is yes or one is no. Okay. So which kind of outcome it would give? Logistic, already you know that S kind of graph it would return as an S kind of graph, isn't it? So these are just a list of the classification problems, but among these here we are going to learn in detail about Navi Bayes only, not all. Okay, what is the second one? Second one is decision tree algorithm. Decision tree algorithm is used for multi-class representation. Next, third one is random forest. Random forest is forest. Random forest also multi-class, and Navi Bayes algorithm. Navi Bayes also for multi-class. And k nearest neighbors also multi-class. Okay, these are the some of the algorithms, classification algorithms under a neural network. Is it clear? We are having some classification algorithms are there: logistic regression, decision tree algorithm, random forest, Navi Bayes, and k nearest neighbor, and so on. All right. So under these all, here we are going to learn about a navy base. Now we are going to learn navy base classification algorithm only. Why? Because it is there in our syllabus, isn't it? The remaining all also come under, already have learned these all the algorithms in data mining and data warehousing, isn't it? These are all the concept under data warehousing and data mining. But now in neural network, as per your syllabus, we are going to learn only one classification method, that is a navy based classifier. Clear? Okay, let us see what is navy based classifier. A navy based classifier, a probability based on classifier. What it is, a navy based classifier is a probability based, okay, probability based classifier based on Bayes algorithm, according to the concept of dependent probability. It calculates the problem that each of the features of a data point exists in each of the target classes. Okay, actually navy based classifier is coming under Bayes algorithms. There are multiple number of Bayes theorems, which means Bayes algorithms are there in real time. So among them, a navy based classifier is one of the Bayes algorithm. And even navy based algorithms, also different types of navy based algorithms are there. Here we are going to discuss about only one, right? So how it is, actually we know that statistics, right? So according to your stats, here navy based classifier is by using this navy based classifier, we are going to find out the probability of classes. Okay, what is the probability of a particular class? Based on the probability only, you are going to take the decision in future, isn't it? For example, in day-to-day life, we are receiving many kinds of mails, isn't it? So in day-to-day life, we are receiving many kinds of mails. So under the all the mails, for example, I'll show an example to you. Okay, if you will observe this screen, okay, under this screen, this is one my mail ID. So here, the under the inbox, okay, in my mail ID there is a inbox. Under this here, I have four portions. One is primary mails, social mails, promotions, and updation mails. Here I can have four kinds of, I have received the mails. Okay, so that the mails are maybe coming under a primary group or social group or promotions or updates. How the mails would be, okay, filtered, separated, and sent to these particular groups? How it is possible to do? Okay, based on the words, how they were separate the males and forward it if it is primary, and how they are deciding whether it is primary kind of male or it is a social kind of male or promotions or updates like that. Okay, based on the some voting, checking the voting. So if the votes of that particular male is belonging to frequent vote, then they may be sent to a okay primary males. If that males are related to some, automatically here the LinkedIn vote is there. The LinkedIn in the sense, okay, Facebook, LinkedIn, these type of votes come under a social network, right? So that's why based on these votes, this kind of males are coming under a social group. After that promotions, after that updates. So every day we are receiving some kind of males. Okay, those males are separated based on the group which I have okay framed here. So primary males or social males or promotions or updates, how these are filtered and these are saved under that particular category in the sense based on the votes checking. Here one kind of votes checking is going on. That is also one algorithm here. It's almost near to base algorithms, isn't it? And not only that word, the probability of that particular word, the probability of that particular word. Okay, based on the probability only, here we are going to separate the males. Right. So this is the one of the example here. Okay, in the same way, Navier-Bayes classifier is also worked. So based on the probability of that particular data items, okay, we are going to filter the data. Decide this particular data is belonging to the which class, isn't it? So that is the Navier-Bayes classifier here. Okay. So in this model, the features of that models are conditionally independent. The features in the sense attributes of that particular models are conditionally independent attributes. Here we are going to take to perform the Navier-Bayes classifier here, right? And what are the strengths of this Navier-Bayes classifier? It is simple to implement. Okay, we can implement easily, but this Navier-Bayes also having different kinds. But apart from that, okay, many algorithms, it is little bit simple one. Okay. And it does not involve any kind of literature calculations. It may have one formula. Based on that formula only, it is going to calculate the data or probabilities based on that. It won't take future references or something, isn't it? And it is accurate for large set of problems, large data sets. Okay, if we have a large number of data sets, which means what is the data set here? Data set is a collection of data in the form of either rows and columns, isn't it? A large data sets, a table of data with multiple number of columns and with multiple number of rows. The table, if we have a table with n number of columns and n number of rows, that particular table is called a data set here. So if there is a large data set, we can have the large data set, then also we can get the accurate results based on this particular algorithm. Okay, and it can also be used to construct multi-layer decision trees. Okay, already you know the concept of decision tree. Decision tree is also a one kind of tree. Okay, based on the attribute importance, here we are going to
take that attribute for particular testing purpose. Okay, here also in decision tree also we are going to construct the tree for the attributes of that particular table. But here we are going to consider the important attributes only into that particular decision tree, isn't it? So this particular Naive Bayes algorithm is also used to construct multi-layer decision trees, isn't it? And what are the weaknesses of this particular Naive Bayes? So it is very sensitive to the set of categories selected. So what are the categories we have selected in, under this particular table? So it would give some little bit sensitive results. And if the categories are overlapped or if they are unknown categories, it leads to reduction in accuracy. If we have some unknown kind of categories, data we have, maybe it would give some approximate results, not accurate results. Isn't it? If we can give already, if suppose previously I have taken some data points or data sets. Okay, this is one group of data set and this is another group of data set. Okay, if the new data item is, okay, this is the new data item. So clearly we can say that this is belong to this group or this group. Okay, so accurate result we can find. For example, not this. Okay, some one point may become like this. This is the one new data item. Okay, so now tell me this particular data item is belonging to this group or this group? This group or this group? Isn't it? If the data item is like this, then we can clearly say that it belongs to this particular group, isn't it? But if the data item is this one, if the data item is this one, like one kind of slash, so this belongs to this group or this group? This is a little bit difficult to say. We don't know exactly. So this in this kind of situation, maybe it may be belongs to this one or it may be belongs to this one. How we may say, okay, if it is a cross line means, if you draw one small line like this means it belongs to tick. Or if it is a cross line means, if you can draw one more line opposite to this means it is a cross, isn't it? So this is a cross. Okay, we don't know exactly this particular symbol is now belonging to which group, which pattern. So in such kind of situation, it may give approximate results. That is the weakness of this particular Naive Bayes algorithm. And here we are having one example for, there is a formula and one example is there for Naive Bayes algorithm. Okay, we'll discuss this example in tomorrow's class.